I bought $1,000 worth of air filters. Let's find out who makes the best one.
To answer that question, I did 130 hours of testing with 11 different filter types from 6 different brands. In this video, I focus on the results of these tests as they relate to your home HVAC unit and the standard 4-filter DIY air purifier. The goal is to find out how to keep the air in your home as clean as possible. If you want to know how they were tested and why they performed as they did, you can watch my deep dive video on the subject next. But for now, 1, 2, and 4-inch filters will battle it out to see who's best. 3M, Nordic Pure, Filter By, Aerostar, HDX, and a reusable K&N filter were tested for their ability to capture smoke particles. As a control, I will also test a HEPA-rated air filter called the Air Doctor 3000 with a clean air delivery rate of 340. I ran the main smoke test in my garage that has a floor space of 500 square feet and an air volume of about 5,500 cubic feet. I didn't bother organizing it because I figured that all the extra obstructions in the space would help create a more realistic view of how these filters would perform inside a full house. I used this pollution meter to see how well each type of filter handles small particles from PM10 to PM1. PM is the designation for particles ranging from 10 microns to under 1 micron in size. Pollen, household dust, shop dust, pet dander, mold spores, bacteria, smoke from your kitchen or from wildfires, welding fumes, viruses, factory, and vehicle pollution are all super small particles. By testing with smoke, we are testing for anything in this size range. I burned 3 sticks of incense with a fan running for 15 minutes until a hazardous air quality level was reached. Then I put out the incense and ran the fan for an additional 5 minutes until the air was thoroughly mixed. Then I recorded until the AQI, or Air Quality Index, reached 45. Down from an upper level of 450, a 90% reduction in airborne particles. The bulk of my tests were centered on this type of 4-filter design, but the results also apply to your home's HVAC system. Here is how long it took these 20 by 20-inch filters to clean the air. Despite the more restrictive nature of the 3M MERV 14 filter, it performed best overall. In fact, all of the 3M filters performed best in their respective MERV categories. The MERV system is used to classify how well an air filter removes small particles from the air. If you are concerned about air quality, I do not recommend anything under a MERV 11. To show why, I tested a set of MERV 8 filters made by HDX. First, let's look at the natural level of smoke dissipation in the space with a fan running and a small roof vent that lets in some fresh air. It took about 10 hours for the smoke to dissipate on its own, and here is the performance of the MERV 8 filters. These are designed to collect large dust particles and things like pet hair, but not a whole lot more. Moving up to the MERV 11 filters, it took the 3M filter 55 minutes to clean the air, followed by the reusable K&N filter, and lastly, the Aerostar. At the MERV 13 level, the 3M filter topped the chart at 47 minutes, followed by the 2-inch and 4-inch filter by, 1-inch HDX filter, and about 20 minutes later, the 1-inch filter by across the line. For the MERV 14 level, the 3M filter produced the best results seen in this test, taking only 38 minutes to clean the air in this large space. It was followed by the 2-inch Nordic Pure that came in at 54 minutes, and 45 minutes after that, the 1-inch Nordic Pure finished the test. Let's look at the top 5 performers across all MERV levels. The 3M MERV 14 filter is easily the best performer. The 3M MERV 13 comes in second. For a time, the 2-inch Nordic Pure MERV 14 was out in front of the 3M MERV 11, but it finished the test at nearly an identical place in time. 21 minutes after the 3M MERV 14 crossed the line, the 2-inch filter by met the testing requirements. I also ran some tests with just a single air filter on the back of a box fan. The filter was placed on top of my workbench for the best possible airflow. Keep in mind that if the unit is on the floor, the results will be about 20% lower than what is shown here. Overall, the performance is significantly reduced from the 4-filter configuration because of an increase in what is called static pressure. More on that later. I did not test every filter option yet, but based on these results, you can safely say that the single filter performance is about one half of the performance of the 4-filter designs. The best performance again was the 3M MERV 14, which removes all smoke in 1 hour and 15 minutes. Next in was the 4-inch filter by MERV 13 and the 3M MERV 11, with a time of 1 hour and 52 minutes. Despite the low performance of the K&N filter in the previous test, I decided to test it again in this configuration because it is reusable. You can literally wash it every couple of months and it will last for 5 to 10 years or maybe even more. The trade-off is that it takes 2 hours and 38 minutes to pull a hazardous level of particulate from the air. If you do not have huge levels of smoke or dust in the air, this might be your best option. Think for a minute about how many times your HVAC system runs per day and how long it runs each time. In the summer, the total daily runtime may not drop below 8 hours of use per day. That is about 20 minutes of runtime per hour on average. At that rate, you can say that the 3M MERV 14 in this test would take 12 hours to completely remove one stick of evenly mixed incense smoke from the air, and the K&N would take 24 hours of AC runtime. If those numbers do not sound fast enough for your needs, you may want to invest in an air filter that runs continuously like these do-it-yourself options or a HEPA filter. Now let's look at the graph everyone's been waiting for, price versus performance. This chart shows results from the 4-filter configuration similar to a Corsi-Rosenthal filter box or my Model C air filter kit. All were powered by an Air King box fan that is about 20% more powerful than the average box fan. If you're looking for single filter performance for your furnace, the lowest cost in this configuration will also be the lowest cost in your HVAC. These calculations are based on the cost of 4 filters divided by how many sticks of incense the configuration is theoretically capable of removing from the air in 30 days' time, if running continuously. The cost shown is the price of removing 10 sticks of incense from the air. The K&N is the highest initial cost, but because the filters last for years, its long-term cost is easily the lowest overall. The 3M MERV 14 actually gets the award for the most cost-effective disposable filter with the highest possible performance. It's followed closely by the 3M MERV 13 and the 3M MERV 11. Only the 2-inch filter by MERV 13 and 2-inch Nordic Pure MERV 14 came close. The Aerostar MERV 11 and the 1-inch Nordic Pure MERV 14 had the highest cost of operation of the filters tested. The top performers here are not necessarily inexpensive. The cost of filters also fluctuates, so it can be good to price check the top performers in this test before making a purchase. Sometimes you can catch a set of filters on sale and rearrange the items in this chart. Links to all of the filters are in the description. Another thing that is important to consider for furnace filters is how large your HVAC filter is versus how much air it handles. For every 1 ton of AC power, the fan generally pushes 400 CFM through the air. Something that I really love about the 3M filters is that their static pressure rating is printed right on the side. Ideally, you should try to keep your airflow level in line with a static pressure between 0.1 and 0.2 if possible. I think it's interesting that at least for 3M brand filters, the low MERV rated filters have virtually the same ratings as the high MERV filters. Something that I hear a lot is that high MERV filters are too restrictive for use in HVAC systems. I think that may be true in many off-brand cases, but maybe not for 3M brand filters. Keep in mind that all the results in this video are from when the filters are new. The performance over time will change as the filters get dirty. Once I am able to test for this, I will put out another video on the subject. My control unit, the AirDoctor 3000 HEPA filter, at least as far as filter replacement costs are concerned, performs well but not as good as the 3M configurations. It also managed to clean the air in the garage in just over 1 hour, which is a respectable score. It is a fine air purifier that should work well in most scenarios. I conducted my garage test in a similar way to a test conducted at the University of Toronto. Their test found that the Blue Air 211 performed just about as well as the AirDoctor for a lower price. For in-home use in large spaces, this might be the best option for a HEPA filter. Another thing I would like to mention is the real benefit of having an affordable air quality monitor at your disposal. It can be an eye-opening experience to find out what's really in your air. There is a link to this device in the description. My air filter kits will be available for purchase within a week or two of this video launch. For anyone that is interested in getting one of the Model C prototype units mailed to them for free, be one of the first 200 people to put a relevant comment down below. Now that we've covered the most popular DIY air filtration method, the 20-inch Corsi-Rosenthal filter box, in the next video I will get into my other air filter kits, the Model A and Model B. One manages to filter all the smoke out of the garage in just 20 minutes, and the other achieves the lowest operational cost of any DIY air filter that I tested. That video should be out in a few days, so watch that next. Stay safe, everybody, and thanks for watching.